Well, I got the hay feeding done. Yeah, I guess it's time I tell y'all what I've been holding you up for. Hello, Blackjack. Hello, son. How are you? How are you? Yeah. You miss Melinda, huh? You miss her? Yeah. I know. I guess it's time you know. I guess it's time you know. I guess it was about a week ago. Maybe, yeah, it's been about a week ago. Melinda moved out. She took almost everything we had in here with her. I got my old couch back. I had lucky it was out in the shed. And I had a little microwave in the shed, a little hot plate. I just couldn't believe this all happened right here at the holidays. This place empty. She even took the cabinets. When they say a woman will wipe you clean, man, they ain't joking. So here I am on Thanksgiving. So it might be why y'all haven't been seeing a video. She says she needs her space. Says she felt crowded, choked. Just unreal. Just empty walls now. Empty room. Yeah. At least I still have the kitchen sink. They say they'll take everything and the kitchen sink. She left me the kitchen sink. Oh. Yeah, so Melinda moved out. She moved out right next door. Look here. There she is, right there.
Yeah.
If y'all hadn't figured it out by now, Cap and I, we have had a project of him moving out of my house. I had rented the downstairs portion of my house out for probably about the last 9 years.
9 years, because since
I stayed in it
I
briefly for a short period of time between some renters. And it was a sacrifice that I made to one thing. I was going overseas a lot and I was working so much, I really didn't make use of the house. And the next thing was that at in the midst of all that, I saw it as a way for additional income, and I've got pretty good rent out of this for years now. And I used that money. I didn't waste it. I reinvested it. It's earned me more money. And I've been smart with that and have money just keep folding exponentially. And I've told all of you, you can do it too. But I felt that the sacrificial time of giving up my personal home was long enough. And I wasn't going to build another home here. I'm going to just recover my home that I built with my own two hands when I was in my 20s. And my early 30s. And so this is it. I'm happy to be back in it. Melinda
Yes,
has,
I'm happy too.
when I first told her, she was like,
I
"No,
refused it.
we need the income." I said, "Well, this is one time I'm not giving you a choice. The decision's already been made. I'm telling you after the fact."
Plus, also, like, you seen some of our video that we told that I love Kevin style or, you know, country style. So, there we go.
Yeah, when I built this house, it is a lot of wood. It's a lot of knotty pine. It's a lot of cedar. And this house is like wood inside. It's got a very country theme to it. And here we are. So now the room that I stayed in back there for all this time that I made like an apartment in the back, that was originally like my game room. I had a pool table and the stuff there. It was a hangout spot, and it's already returning to that very fast, very fast. So this is it's the house I built years ago. We've already been in here moving and decorating. So you can see a lot's been happening in here already. Hold on, I see somebody coming to our door. So I tell you what though, for the person that was hesitant about the decision, she practically moved Cap out.
Of course, I think before that we need an extra income.
We made a deal with Cap, you know, or I did, and we had a timeline set. So Kat was trying to work within that timeline, and we're rebuilding that place over next door. And Kat said, my stuff, every time that we're gone, is inching and inching closer to the door. And his stuff on the porch is inching and inching down the porch. But
I keep moving slowly.
Yeah, for the person that was like, No, I want all that income. We need all that income, which we don't need all that income. I keep telling her that. We don't need all of that income. And but you got to appreciate a woman that's thinking about finances. You got to appreciate that, right?
Of course, more income, more enjoyment.
So nevertheless, she got in here cleaning and moving us in like super fast. She actually moved us in, honestly, too fast, because I had things that I wanted to do in the kitchen. There was some remodel work, some retexturing, a little bit of tape and bed work I wanted to do and all, and she done moved everything in before we even got that done. No, James, let's don't move there. Fastest one through the door. So I'll show you a little bit here. You see Mel, she's been in here just busy decorating. And as I said, I did this with a lot of cedar work when I did this. Cedar ceiling up behind me. This is where you see there was the person that originally taped and bedded for me years ago didn't do a really good job and they were coming loose. So I peeled them all the other day, but now we got furniture stuck in front of it. But, and look here, Thanksgiving. Yeah, Thanksgiving. Melinda's been cooking pies. And me, I've got a turkey going in here. I'm browning it right now. Yeah, this is my casa that I built years ago. I'm so happy to share it now with Melinda for the first time. We've been married for years now. And this is like a brand new place to you, right?
Yeah.
So the time of sacrifice is over. It's been long enough. It's my little pantry here. Y'all might like this. It's a little neat idea. It's like a cabinet, but you got these little rollouts. See here? It's got even more down in the back. I need to install a light in here. It's got more storage shelves down into the back of it. It's pretty neat. These are just on door hinges. Yep, just on door hinges. See right there? I made it where you can store all your large stuff up in the top up here. It's nice and deep. And I'll give you a little bit more tour of the whole home some other time. But you remember where our stove was and all those cabinets? Like Ernie, you remember those cabinets that was on the wall? Well, they're gone. It's where this hole is here now. This is where I originally had a set of French doors. I've got to get it trimmed back out also, where we had closed it in before. So down here, we have already been returning it back to a game room. I had a kitchen window there that looked down into this room. I had to pull sheetrock to get in there and open that opening back up. And I've got pool table I've had in storage out. And got a couple of my jukebox. I got my jukebox here. Pinballs right here. And dart machine right there. Still going to finish this room out like we were planning on, because it'll go right with the theme of the rest of the house. But a lot of these cabinets have came out. They went in storage. We may use them in a future rent house. So here we are with that. And I tell you what, I'm happy. I've got my office back as well, which is also a complete cedar room. Like I said, I'll show you a tour of all that at a later date. But I have lived debt-free my whole life. I built this house debt-free, built it myself. As a young man, I had honestly not much of a clue what I was doing. I wasn't a house builder, but I built it. I built it 2x6 walls too, not 2x4, 2x6. And I wanted to be strong. I wanted to be long-lasting. And I did it. I worked for the money. I bought the materials. I come home. I built the house. I did a lot of it at nighttime. You know, you're younger, you got more energy. I did a lot of it off of halogen lights at night. And it's a two-story home, as y'all have seen outside before. And so I've got this work to do in here. Y'all can see the marks where I pulled tape and bedding, or pulled the bad joints here recently loose, and Cap's going to get in here, retape those for me. We'll drape out all the kitchen in plastic. Probably need it to anyway. Need to cover the cabinets and get this all done in here. It's a small thing. It'll be a quick project, but I'm so happy to get back into the home that I built debt-free. It was a good sacrifice. That money added up through the years, and the house did not sit empty while I traveled alone, because I did travel for years now before I ever knew Melinda. All right, so sorry for the clickbait. I apologize for that. We gotta have fun, right? You gotta pull your chain sometimes. Gotta mess with you. But listen, so many of you we've come to know so well through commenting and chatting, and y'all being such dedicated subscribers to us. I want to tell you, we really enjoy it a lot. I'm sorry that we've been MIA lately. Now you see what's been up.
Yeah, we've just been busy lately.
Not just with this. We've been dealing with other rent houses, cattle, hauling cattle. Oh my God, that over there, I've been working on my building, and I'm telling you, if I tried to cover 5 minutes of each one in a video, your heads would spin. To keep up with me is like trying to keep up with a tornado. It's just the way it is. And I just want to tell you again that we really appreciate you guys. You're all kind of like a family to us. And I want to tell you, and Mel wants to tell you,
Happy
Thanksgiving.
Everyone.
Enjoy your loved ones and remember your past loved ones. And we all look forward to seeing you again in a very future video.